part two. Yes, so motive alone can't stand up. It's just not good enough. All it can do is arouse your suspicions, and that's it. This case is so close to being a perfect crime, because the perpetrator of this, this was no coincidence, this was no accident. If it was an accident, there'd be all sorts of evidence. There would have been a dead body. No, this was, and this was somebody with some sophistication when it comes to criminal behaviors and a thought-out plan for murder. Do you know, I want to say this before I forget it, even though I'm sort of jumping, that someone in the Anthony household recently destroyed all the remaining pictures of little Kaylee. I'll leave you to let that one cook on your back burner, and let me know when you've got that figured out. Anyway, where was I? Oh, here we are, with no evidence. We don't have a time of death. All we have is the word of George as to the last time anyone saw Casey and Kaylee together. And George's word is not worth the paper it's written on. He has lied continuously on the stand, but not as much as just, but, and Cindy too. You want to hear something really funny? Okay, shortly after the police, after they questioned Casey for a couple of hours there at the house on that very first call, they went ahead and arrested her. They didn't have proof of any murder or anything yet. But they arrested her on lying to police. Yet, what did Cindy do? Just hours earlier, in the very same day, she called up and reported and wanted police assistance and have her daughter arrested for stealing her car. If that isn't lying to the police and giving a false report to police. And it went on and on. This is just one thing. It just went on and on and on between George and Cindy. They were like in a race to see how many lies that they each can tell without ever being held accountable. Now, Casey right now is sitting in jail. She has been judged acquitted in the crime of the murder of Kaylee, but not for lying to the police, which is exactly what her mother and father have been doing since day one. She is sitting in jail for lying to the police. That's it. I mean, you know, this blows my mind when I start looking at these parallels. Okay, they had dry bones. They had a medical examiner who did not do all the right tests. Now, whether these omissions of tests was done on purpose because they didn't want anything messing up their case, and I suspect that, or it was simply because the medical examiner didn't know their stuff. But yet, opening up the skull in a case of murder where you have, you're really searching for any kind of clues at all that will help you, that definitely would have been done because on the inside of the skull, the moisture stays much longer. And so you have, and also in the inner ear area, that's another good area to be the last to go dry. And they know these things. I know these medical examiners know these. I didn't know it until this case came along. But